So I served one term as a regional rep. I actually finished someone's term. I believe it was in the 1990s. And I came on as vice president, which is president-elect, in 2011. And I stepped down as president in 2015. And I stepped down just a few days ago in 2016 as immediate past president. That's a position that takes 1 year, so.
And during your presidency, what did you want to accomplish and what do you consider your biggest accomplishment?
So at the beginning of my presidency, or actually during my vice presidency, I approached Mitch Silver, who was the president of the American Planning Association. And I said, how do you run an organization the stature and size of ACSP? And so he looked at me and he said, how many staff do you have? And I said, maybe 1.2 or 1.5. And so he said, well, you'd better have a very small agenda, because he said, I've been president of American Planning Association and I have something like 80 staff to carry out my agenda, and here is my agenda. He opened up his breast pocket and took out a 3-page agenda. But he said, if you don't really have staff, there's no one to carry it out, and so you'd better be very focused. So based on that, I actually did convene a committee. It's called the Review and Appraisal Committee, and I went to them with a draft agenda that had 3 bullet points. And those 3 bullet points were revolving around the theme of connections. Connections among planning faculty was the first. Connections with diverse peoples, particularly people who are of racial or ethnic minority status, as well as women. And then the third point was connections with the profession. So those were my goals.
And what was ACSP like when you first got involved with it? Your earliest memories?
So my earliest memory actually was as a junior faculty member. My school director was very involved in ACSP. And I'd have to think about what year that would be, but it must have been something in the late 70s, early 1980s. When that person died, Carl Goldschmidt, I read his vita and realized that he was the first executive director of ACSP, and I had not remembered that. I remembered that he was really active and really respected ACSP, but I didn't remember that he was the first executive director, if I ever knew that. So that was really my first exposure. The second exposure was filling out that term, I mentioned that. And then the third period was when I helped to found one of the interest groups, the Planners of Color Interest Group. And I was on the founding task force. There were just like four or five of us. And so I started to attend governing board meetings and to make proposals to the governing board to create the Planners of Color Interest Group. And that it was from that position that eventually I was convinced by my predecessor, Chuck Connerly, to stand for election as vice president, president-elect.
And what do you want to see ACSP accomplish in the future, and what do you perceive as in need of most change?
So I think we've made headway on all the 3 areas that I identified. I think we're still working on all 3 areas. I don't want to go into each one, but I think there are 2 that I think are of major concern. One is essentially helping to bring ACSP more into the world, which is to make more of a visible presence of planning faculty, planning scholarship, planning schools, in part so that we can attract people to the profession and that we can gain standing within the places that we work. So that's really important, but of course that means that we have to be very conscious of standing on certain values. And one of those values is social justice and social equity. And without that, we could just have a visible presence, but we could just be functionaries. So we have to be very careful about those values. So as part of that effort to maintain those same values, we ourselves have to be sure that we remain diverse, that we are welcoming to people of all colors, all ethnic backgrounds, all nationalities, that we're a welcoming place for women. So I think those two go hand in hand, really. We need more presence for planning. We need greater visibility for planning. But we need at the same time to hold on to values, particularly values related to social justice.
Sure, sure. And since your recommendation or discussion with the APA president, going from 1.2 staff members to now 5, it is, I mean, change is usually slow to occur, but maybe slowly but surely those other agendas can really become a reality.
Yes, and I would be the last person to take credit for that. That happened during my watch, but it was inevitable. I mean, it was ridiculous. We were depending on just one person, or during the conference, two or three people to do things that other organizations have real staff for. So I think it was inevitable that we would have to see some way to kind of increase our staff capacity. And of course, Donna Dodd has been able to do that, to help us do that very well.
Sorry. Yeah,
great continuing on.
Oh.
I just wanted to make sure it was going to be quiet.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Lastly, anything else you want to say to the audience that might be watching? You don't have to, but.
Well, I could talk forever. I mean, I'm a teacher, so I have no problem talking. I have obviously a lot of passion for the profession, and for the potential of ACSP. I think 10 years, 15 years from now, I hope that we see even more movement, particularly along those lines or whatever lines the future presidents happen to identify. And it was a real pleasure. I felt honored to be picked for this. Little old girl from South Carolina picked as president. I mean, who would have thought? You know, so I'm very happy to have had this opportunity. So.
Good, good. Thank you.
Okay, all right.
Yay, you're done. Now you
can
enjoy the rest of the conference.